one girl. We meet again. Come to taste my sweet balls of justice again, have you?
I have had it with you and your stupid innuendos, especially when you don't have any balls to begin with.
I'll have you know that my balls are imported from the finest regions of India.
We've been putting up with your shit for over 101 episodes. I am not going to stand for this fucking bullshit for another fucking season.
And just what are you planning to do about it, home run girl?
We've called in a few favors and brought in an expert to handle this one.
I don't believe it. It's my arch nemesis, Belladonna, the only woman that could handle my baseball bat of justice.
That's right, Strikeman. Right up my derriere.
Curse you, Belladonna. You're lucky I have other criminals to attend to. He who fights and runs away, lives to fight another day. Ha ha.
Fuck my life. We're never going to be rid of him, are we?
Well, Natsumi, it looks like our next season is already looking to be just another rehash.
Yeah, but look on the bright side. We finally get to experience the ins and outs of police work in the year 2018. You should be super stoked about this. Real life will always be better than the imagination. Right? Right?
Ugh. I mean, Jesus. Why won't this fucking door open?
Yeah, those new keycards are a bitch, aren't they?
I think mine got stuck. Come on, keycard. Come out. Come out. Come out.
Uh-oh. Are we going to have to kick it down?
Hey, wait a minute. Do you hear something moving around in there?
You think somebody broke into our apartment?
All right. Whoever's in there, this is your first, last, and final warning. Who goes there? I said, who goes there?
Miyuki, do you hear him moving?
Not for long.
Miyuki, wait. I think we're in the wrong apartment.
Sir, in every shooting case involving a white police officer shooting an unarmed black man, in every case, some asshole PR agent has had to come forward to find a way to spin it in order for the police department to save face. I stand before you now, as God is my witness, I am that asshole, the one and only, heaven sent, so that you can get a good night's rest.
That'll never happen. I haven't slept in years.
All right then. How are you going to spin this to save Gobayakawa?
Well, past research and experience has shown that if the victim was indeed guilty of a crime, the jury will be more willing to accept his fate as an act of karma when passing out the verdict.
Meaning?
For example, per se, if some personal use marijuana or cocaine were to be found in his apartment.
Excuse me? We do not plant evidence on murder victims.
Sir, I assure you, nobody actually plants the evidence. It's our word against the victim, and he's not speaking to anybody.
Retroactively incriminating somebody doesn't erase the fact that he was shot in his own apartment without a search warrant. According to Miyuki's own testimony, she wasn't there to investigate a crime. She was off duty.
Do you really think it could work?
But Chief...
It could work. It should work.
It's working already.
Chief... Police policy states that a superior will not issue an unlawful order and an officer will not obey one.
I haven't given an unlawful order. I was asking a question. Did any of you hear me directly give an unlawful order?
You alluded to it.
Did I directly give an unlawful order?
Well, no. Not technically.
Well, then it's settled. We're back to square one, filing manslaughter charges against Officer Kobayakawa.
I was just tossing it out there, really. Surprise. I was testing you.
Get the fuck out.
Right away, sir. Although I must say, the decision of how Botham Jean's death is handled may be the most important decision in your life.
I said, get out.
I'm gone.
Earlier today, the Bokuda Police Department conducted a search of Botham Jean's apartment, backing up Kobayakawa's claims that she shot him from across the room. The search turned up two spent cartridge casings, and 10.4 grams of marijuana sitting on his kitchen counter.
You know, I happen to be a lawyer, and in our profession, This is what we refer to as typical racist horseshit.
Other tenants of the Southside apartment complex have brought into question the details of Kobayakawa's story. Details such as the key card locks on the doors. Kobayakawa claims that the door was left slightly ajar, but the tenants state that the doors always close on their own. Some witnesses even claim that they could hear her banging on the door demanding that he come out.
Yo yo, something is not right about this, you're here. I have never seen a cop on our floor before. We could hear them outside, and it was all police talk, like come out, come out. Botham Jean had a red mat in front of his door to differentiate it from the other apartments. How could she not notice that? How crazy do you have to be to not know you're in the wrong apartment?
According to the Jean family's lawyer, several noise complaints had already been filed against Botham Jean's apartment, all of which came from the downstairs apartments below his, including Miyuki Kobayakawa's. While manslaughter charges are being brought against Kobayakawa right away, many feel the charges should be brought up to murder.
This was clearly an assassination hit. Botham Jean was a leader in our community. This whole thing is an attempt to smear him.
Chief, how could you?
I didn't. Botham Jean's apartment is a crime scene. We're required to search it.
But it's all over the news. Everyone thinks we planted those drugs on him.
How was I supposed to know he really had marijuana? There's a reason irony exists in our vocabulary.
Everyone thinks we're a bunch of murderers. I can't even go to the corner grocery store without getting harassed.
That's why I called in an outside department to investigate this, because I knew everyone would accuse us of putting Kobayakawa's rights over the victims.
It had to be you. I was there. I heard you. They said it was sitting on the kitchen counter. If it wasn't planted, then why didn't they notice it the first time when the police took away the body?
And more than that, if it was planted, then why didn't anybody use that logic before they did it?
I thought I told you to get the fuck out. Bad public relations. Bad public relations.
Right away, sir.
Before we proceed on the case of Botham Jean versus the defendant, could somebody please tell me, where are the lawyers?
Right here, Your Honor.
I'm not familiar with you. Who are you?
I'm everybody's favorite court-appointed defense lawyer.
Court-appointed? That's not a very high goal to have in life.
Yeah, well, sometimes you've got to lower the bar.
Have you even passed the bar?
Of course. After I traveled back in time 2 or 3 times.
Natsumi, you said you would get us a real lawyer.
He is a real lawyer. You heard the man. I wouldn't want anyone else on my side.
Oh no. I'm so totally fucked.
And where is the prosecutor?
Ladies and gentlemen, the mad prosecutor is in.
Didn't I send you to jail for DWI a few years ago?
It's all cool, Judge. I've been on the science swagger ever since. Been kicking it real on a certain magical pimp dex. The real index season 3.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No, we beat a certain magical index 3's release date by at least a month or so. Those fucking pussies still refuse to acknowledge us.
Are you finished yet?
We will be. If Kevin Lee Sever gets off his morning ass and gets back to work again.
Your Honor, this case concerns a serious subject matter that's very near and dear to our hearts. Neither one of us really wants to be the one to defend this cracker police bitch.
Gee willikers. Thanks a lot.
So for the time being, we've agreed to switch roles during this trial. I'll be the prosecutor, and Dr. Evil over here can defend. That.
I swear, it's almost like the two of you ganged up on the real lawyers in the restroom, beat the shit out of them, and stole their clothes.
Oh no, Your Honor. This get-up is all me, and that other brother's get-up is all goodwill.
Wait, you mean you're not even going to defend me?
Why should I? You wanted to go to jail, remember?
It's okay, baby. The Church of Necessary Evil's taken a special interest in you. We got you.
Let the trial commence. Will the prosecutor please make your opening statement?
Your Honor, if a person is driving a car under the influence, and accidentally hits a pedestrian, that death is unintentional, but the result is all the same. If a person is flying on hallucinogenic mushrooms and LSD in their own little fantasy world, only to awaken to a dead body, they were unaware of their actions, but the result is all the same. Regardless of what their intentions were, an innocent human being is still dead. When this usually happens, they are charged with manslaughter. But if an off-duty police officer walks into someone's apartment without a search warrant, and shoots them dead in their own home, under the mistaken fantasy that she was in her own apartment. Are we, as a society, to let her off the hook simply because she was wearing a badge? Officers are used to having to shoot criminals in the line of duty as a part of their job. But in performing this act on a regularity, have they become too trigger-happy to pass out justice? Have they become just as desensitized as a film junkie born and raised on violent cinema? Have we, as law enforcement, allowed ourselves to become desensitized to the value of a human life? Every life has value. The very point of our prison system is to try and rehabilitate those who have fallen, so that they may invest in life again, with dignity. Botham Jean was an innocent human being who managed to go his whole life without a criminal record. To paraphrase his mother, all it took to turn him into a criminal was being murdered by a white officer. If we allow the crime of his death to go unpunished under this argument, then none of us will be safe. Over the course of events leading up to this trial, many have pointed out inconsistencies within Ms. Kobayakawa's testimony. She states that all the floors look identical, that all the apartments look the same. But she fails to note the clearly visible red mat standing outside the apartment. She says the door was ajar, and that she was able to push it open. But witnesses have claimed that they heard her shouting to open up, suggesting perhaps that Botham Jean was really shot at the front door.
Objection, Your Honor. If Botham Jean was shot at the front door, then both bullets would have hit him. Police evidence has shown that one of the bullets missed, and backup that he really was standing across the room when it happened. It wouldn't surprise me in the slightest if Botham Jean was eating a bowl of ice cream.
Objection sustained.
Records from the apartment management also show that the defendant filed a noise complaint against Botham Jean, along with several others who were living below him, thus implying a possible motive. The defendant has stated that she came home tired, perhaps irritable even, after a hard day's work. Is it so bold to suggest that Botham Jean may have been playing his music loud, thus setting her off?
Are there witnesses that can attain that Botham Jean was playing music at that time?
That's a good question. It didn't say that in the news articles I had to work off of.
The defendant has pled guilty to manslaughter, but it feels like she had other options before she fired off the shots. For example, in her testimony, she gave verbal commands that she states that Botham Jean ignored. But was she in danger? She could have easily backed out into the well-lit hallway and waited for him to come out. In that time, she could have also tried to call the police. Instead, she fired off two shots into the darkness, to show who was in control, only to ironically have the tables flipped on her when the lights came on and she realized her mistake. Her authority and ego as a police officer finally got the better of her. And in the process, Botham Jean paid the ultimate price: his life. Once again, when a drunk person hits someone with their car, it happens too quickly for them to react. But something does not add up about this. We ask that the charges and sentence be raised to murder.
Oh my goddess. You are the worst lawyer ever.
I aim to please.
Need I remind you that this is a cartoon trial? Those expecting courtroom accuracy can suck my fucking dick. Would the defense please rise to make their opening statements?
Your Honor, first off, let's take a step back to the white elephant in the room. Mainly, the red doormat that people just cannot seem to shut up about. Can our animator flash us a picture of just how red that doormat is? Goddamn. That is a very red doormat. Makes you wonder how anybody could miss it. But those willing to cast the first stone might want to reinforce their glass house. You see, there's this magical medical phenomenon that nobody wants to own up to. An occurrence that happens to all of us when we are tired after a hard day's work. It's called the stupids. Everybody sitting in this courtroom, from Exhibit GED to Exhibit Harvard, has suffered a case of the stupids. It is the great leveler of man. We all get it. Why, I myself once accidentally burst in on my naked niece who was taking a shower. The locked door should have told me that something was wrong, but did I listen to my judgment? No. What judgment? The stupids clouded that. The stupids is so powerful a mental illness that it drags you off into your own little world. For example, a person on parking garage floor 4 can accidentally believe they're on floor 3. A person walking down a hallway identical to the one they see every day can take no notice of the newly red doormat that has magically been gifted in front of their door. Rest assured, folks, Even white police officers can come down with a case of the stupids.
Objection, Your Honor. Our current president has a severe case of the stupids. And he's still able to fulfill the requirements of his job.
Overruled. Donald Trump's job is to pick up a ballpoint pen and sign whatever the GOP tells him to. Any moron can do his job better, including Forrest Gump.
Your Honor, there is one more piece of last-minute evidence that we would like to contribute. Officer Kobayakawa's text messages before the shooting. Over the course of this trial, the general public has repeatedly accused the Bokuto Police Department of hiding something. For example, when the Bokuto Police came to investigate the shooting, their chief called a little huddle to figure out how to handle the situation. We now know what that hidden evidence is. Officer Kobayakawa was sending sex text messages to her boyfriend Officer Ken the White Hawk. That is why she was so distracted that she didn't realize she was on the wrong floor of their apartment complex. She was distracted by her iPhone 7. During these text messages, Officer Kobayakawa made repeated jokes about the assassination of Martin Luther King Jr. I kid you not. For real. She made jokes about the shooting of a black community leader. Only to seconds later enter the apartment of another black community leader. And then she shot him while he was eating a bowl of ice cream watching television on the couch wrapped up in his blanket. I realize how ironic this all must sound, but that is the truth about life and death, that real life will always be stranger than fiction.
Objection, Your Honor.
Overruled. The prosecutor's evidence is credible.
Now, before we proceed, I might ask to the jury to consider this. When you pass sentence, don't think of the angry mob of black society that's waiting outside those courtroom doors, viciously yearning to tear you limb from limb. Don't think of all the new and amazing uses they will find for your testicles. Should you render a verdict that they should deem unfair? Oh no, white jury. We are in this together. To prove once and for all, that in the Bokuto Police Department, if you shoot a brother in his own home, we got your back. And never forget, that when you go home after escaping that angry mob, you will forever cherish those magical jury paychecks that are slightly lesser than a week's work at McDonald's for your efforts. Never forget to do the white thing.
You mean, do the right thing.
That's what I said, do the white thing.
Never mind.
I am so fucking screwed. I'm going to be bumping pussies in prison for life. I just know it.
Son, what you just said right there, that sounded like a threat to the jury.
Oh, it's not a threat. It's a promise.
I will not sit back and allow justice to be decided by the rope of a lynch mob. Botham Jean was found with marijuana in his apartment. In the state of white delusional fantasyland, I hereby declare his death to be an act of karma. This case is dismissed. Miyuki Kobayakawa, you are free to go.
Wait, what?
Yes, you hear that, Miyuki? We're free to go.
See, nothing bad's gonna happen to you. We both knew what the outcome of this trial was going to be before we walked into the courtroom.
Sad but true. It happens every fucking time. The white police officer gets a get out of jail free card. The white police officer gets a get out of jail free card.
Oh my goddess. This doesn't make me feel better. This makes me feel even worse. Wait a minute. Aren't you supposed to be the Time Lord that Natsumi keeps telling me about?
Indeed I am.
But you could easily travel back in time and stop me from shooting Botham Jean. Why don't you?
You're not thinking interdimensionally, Miyuki. Bad Goddess is a cartoon. Yes, we can Photoshop Botham Jean back to life. But in Kevin Nice's world, nothing can bring him back. Every day, Botham Jean's mother and father have to live with this. And no cartoon, no matter how satirical, can ever bring him back.
But, look at the bright side. Pretty little girl like you gets to kill a man, then go home and sleep at night. Snug as a bug in the rug. Must feel pretty good to have that privilege. Some of, ahem, us, will never know what that feels like.
But this can't be the end. There has to be a way to make things right. There has to be a way.
There is a way. It's called atonement. To rehabilitate is to invest in life again with dignity.
But how can I atone if they've already let me off the hook?
You can come to the future with me.
Schooled. What are you doing here?
I'm the goddess of the future. And very much like a certain plagiaristic Charles Dickens holiday classic, I've come to show you what happens every time a white officer is let off for the crime of shooting a black man, you know. Like Pottersville in It's a Wonderful Life.
You don't mean...
Yes, I've come to show you a replay of the Ferguson riots. Look deep into my eyes.
The time has come.
Miyuki. What's happened to our hometown? Everyone has gone completely crazy.
Kenny. No. It's not my fault. I thought I was defending my home.
Miyuki. Help me. The protesters are cannibals. The protesters are eating me alive. Help.
Kenny. Come back. Don't leave me here.
Miyuki. Oh, Miyuki. It's so horrible. The protesters ate Yoriko. They roasted her over an open flame and ate her alive. It's so horrible. And now they're coming for me. Miyuki. Help me.
Scold. Make it stop. Scold. Please make it stop.
But Miyuki, I can't make it stop. I don't have the power to change anything. For as long as human beings will allow racism and fascism in their hearts, this is the future that will come to be.
But Scold, this isn't the future. This is now. This is all happening right now.
And you contributed to it. I know that you meant no harm. You and Botham Jean were both victims of circumstance. You were both co-opted to suit everyone's agendas. Nobody can bring themselves to believe it was an accident. There have just been too many cases in the past where the police got away with it, so now they believe no one.
Dr. Want, I'm begging you. Please bring him back. Please bring back Botham Jean. I'm sorry. Please bring him back.
Miyuki, Botham Jean is dead. You can't bring him back. That is how precious that our lives are. We only get one shot, and then we're gone forever. All that is left of us are the stories that we leave behind. The friendships and the families that we have made. If you truly want to help Botham Jean, all you have to do is tell his story. Don't let him be lost and forgotten in the darkness. Don't let him fade away like the social media fad of the week. None of us can fight the forces of darkness alone. All we can do is reach out to one another and get everyone to wake up.
Wake up, wake up. That's right. This is all just a terrible nightmare. All I've got to do is wake up. Wait, where am I?
Miyuki, are you okay? We were only halfway through our Spike Lee marathon when you passed out.
Spike Lee? My head is so groggy. Is Botham Jean still alive?
Botham Jean, where have you been? Amber Geiger shot him in his own home. It's been all over the news. Or at least it used to be. It feels like it just sort of faded out of social media after a week or so. As if it was the fad of the week, only to be replaced with the next tragedy.
But I don't want to forget. I want to remember. Every officer should remember that every life is precious.